दिस इज रवि कुमार असोसिएट प्रोफेसर ईसी डिपार्टमेंट सेंट मार्टिन्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव ए ओवरव्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक्स. Electromagnetics and its applications are electromagnetic waves where they will be applied and where I will go to antennas. Later I will give the basics of what are the antennas, how electromagnetic waves are propagated through antennas, and in detail I will discuss about the guided mediums, that is microwave devices. These are the three concepts which I am going to in detail going to give a overview. So electromagnetics. So what is meant by electromagnetic wave? Electromagnetic wave, we have heard about the electrical signal and there is a magnetic force, but we didn't hear about an electromagnetic wave. So what is an electromagnetic? So electromagnetic wave is nothing but the wave which is consisting of both electric field component as well as magnetic field component, which are always perpendicular to each other. So electric field and magnetic field, both which are perpendicular to each other, and its resultant propagation will be along the Z direction. Its resultant propagation will be along Z direction, which is nothing but root over E square plus H square. Either it can be E x square plus H y square or H x square plus E y square. Either the component, whatever it may be, the electric field and magnetic field, which are inducing, one is inducing the other. So these types of signals, which are called as electromagnetic signals. And these electromagnetic signals are time-variant fields and time-invariant fields. So these electromagnetic fields are two types. One is time-variant, another one is time-invariant. So considering time-variant, where we will use these time-variant fields? So when there is a movement of the electromagnetic signal, which is changing with respect to time, if it is changing with respect to time, then this type of signal, they are considered as time-varying fields, and which are independent of the variation of the time, then they are called as time-invariant fields. So whatever it may be, the electromagnetic signals are made to propagate through antenna structures. Antennas are used as these are metallic structures. Antennas are nothing but a metallic structure which is used for transition of this electromagnetic signals from one medium to another. So now coming to in details about this microwave circuit. What is meant by microwave circuit or microwave device? So we are telling that antenna should be connected to some guided medium. That guided medium can be either a transmission line or it can be a waveguide structure. So coming to that, these microwaves. In an electromagnetic signal, microwaves are having very important role, where micro refers to tininess. Micro means tiny. These are called tiny waves. Then these microwaves are having 1 foot wavelength. What are microwaves? Microwaves are tiny waves, and this is having 1 foot wavelength. 1 foot wavelength. So this 1 foot wavelength, generally if it is considered 26.5 centimeters, if it is considered, then if you convert it into the frequencies, then the equivalent frequencies what we are having is 984 megahertz, and this is the frequency, and this is the wavelength what we will be having is somewhere around 26.3 centimeters. If you are using the formula F equal to C by lambda, and if you substitute C in 3 into 10 power 10 centimeters per second, and wavelength if you are considering it as some 26.3 centimeters, around you will get around 984 megahertz, and it is approximately, it is given as 1 gigahertz. It is approximately given as 1 gigahertz. That frequencies which is having 1 gigahertz frequencies and the wavelengths are in centimeters, these waves are called as microwaves. And these microwaves, even then, if this wavelength is getting decreased, further decreased, then you will come with the another type of frequencies that are called millimeter waves. They are millimeter waves. Millimeter waves. These millimeter waves will have a wavelength in millimeters, and the frequencies are increasing, further increasing, and these frequencies which are operating at a millimeter wave frequency, these are called as millimeter waves. Okay, so around in a radio frequency band of around 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz up to 1 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz, these band of frequencies are called as microwave band frequencies. Microwave band frequencies. Okay. And from 30 gigahertz to some around 300 gigahertz, you will be having submillimeter waves. They are millimeter and submillimeter waves. They are having millimeter waves and submillimeter waves. Submillimeter waves. So these are frequencies. You have to now understand what is the importance of these frequencies. Now, if you want to do an application at the lowest frequencies, you can transmit one or two applications you can perform. But if you consider 1 gigahertz frequency signal, if you are considering 1 gigahertz frequency signal, for example, if you are having an FM, you are operating FM, you will be around 100 or 102 or 105 megahertz frequencies are required. So how many types of these type of channels can be operated if you use this 1 GHz bandwidth of frequencies? You can operate like this FM channel. That means you can accommodate around 100 channels you can accommodate at a time. Okay, so 10 channels can be accommodated. 10 type of channels. So you will be having 1000 megahertz. So it is having 1000 megahertz. Means if you consider 100 one channel, like that 10 channels can be accommodated in this 1 gigahertz frequency range. So like this, the bandwidth is being improved. The one thing you have to consider is when you are considering the microwave, your bandwidth is improved, and because of this greater bandwidth availability, you can perform so many applications in a single step. That means you need not modulate every time, you need not modulate every time, and you need not multiply the signal and transmit the only at lower frequencies. At a single step, you can transmit n number of application channels with some guard band, and it can be transmitted at a time. So this is the main first advantage of shifting to the microwave frequencies. And the second advantage of shifting to the microwave frequencies is it is the antenna size will be decreased. So when you are improving that, you are going for the higher frequencies. When you are going for the higher frequencies, then obviously at higher frequencies, your wavelength of the antenna will be short. That wavelength will be short. So at higher frequencies, you will be having at a higher frequencies, the diameter of the antenna will be decreased. The diameter of the antenna will be decreased. Because of this diameter of the antenna decrease, you can have a very smaller antenna which is more effectively used in, and it can be more effectively embedded in a particular place where it can be conformed into a particular place, and it can be carried to a particular place where it is not fixed, mobility will be increased. If your antenna size is decreased and you get the mobility of that particular antenna can be increased, and it can be used for several purposes. So this is another advantage of shifting to the higher frequencies. So another advantage we are having, and later when you are moving to the higher frequencies, the devices are less immune to the noise. When you compare to the signal to noise ratio, the signal level of the particular device will be increased and the noise level will be dropped down. Obviously, that particular antenna can be used, or a particular device can be used for with a good signal quality, and fidelity will be increased. And for that particular antenna, fidelity of that particular antenna will be increased. So when you are operating at the micro frequencies, and another thing is impedance matching problem will not occur if you are operating that particular antenna. When you are connecting with the waveguide structures, your impedance matching problem can also be reduced. So these are the different advantages which can happen when you are moving to the higher frequencies. So now, what are the limitations of the conventional devices? Later we have to know what is the limitations of the conventional devices at lower frequencies. When you are operating the devices at lower frequencies, that means micro devices at the lower frequencies, what are the limitations which you are getting? The one is called as transit time effect. When you are operating, and what is transit time? Transit time is nothing but the time taken by the electrons to move from cathode to anode. This is called as transit time. So when you are operating at the lower frequencies, the time taken by the electrons to move from the cathode to anode will be high. And so transit time effect is nothing but the time taken by the electrons to move from cathode to anode, that is time, it is given by tau equal to d by v naught. That means if it is v naught is the velocity of electron, and the time tau is nothing but the time taken by the electron to move from cathode to anode, and d is the distance between the cathode to anode, then this transit time will be more affected when you are using the lower frequencies for the higher frequency operation. And next one, inter-electrode capacitance. Another problem which will occur is inter-electrode capacitance. So when you are operating these conventional tubes at microwave frequencies, like normal devices, which are like resistors, normal capacitors, normal resistors, if you want to operate with this microwave devices, then obviously another problem what we are going to get is the inter-electrode capacitance. That means the capacitance which will be developed inside a circuit, when if you are applying some circuit, for example, here you will be developing the capacitances for this circuit, where you use the source, voltage source, some capacitances will be developed, that is called as inter-electrode capacitance. That means between the electrodes of the device, there will be some capacitance developed which will be restricting the flow of energy from the source to destination. That which will stop flowing of energy from source to destination. So this type of capacitance is called as inter-electrode capacitance. Another problem what we are going to face is lead inductance. So here, lead inductance is the term which is nothing but at the leads, when you are connecting the circuit with a particular source and with some resistance values, and this is the load resistance you are having, and here at this load terminal the power should be dropped. Actually the voltage should be dropped, that means the voltage should be dropped. At this point, some inductance will be developed here, which will be restricting the load drop, and it is, there will be a dissipation occurs automatically. This type of inductance, which is called as lead inductance. This is another type of problem which will be faced. And another problem what we are going to face in this is inter-disturbance between the components. Because of the wear and tear of the components, the tuning effect can be disturbed. The tuning effect can be disturbed.